What's up, gamers and weebs? Before we start, I just want to say thank you again so much for 500 subscribers. 500 subscribers, that means a lot to me. Give yourselves a nice round of applause. We made it. We're going to keep growing and growing. I love making content, videos, and streaming. I just love interacting with you guys in general. And to celebrate, I'm going to be answering all the questions you asked me through Discord, YouTube, and Twitter. So let's get right into the Discord questions first. Ranit asks, at what point in your life did you become so horny? Well, I started becoming horny around 8th grade to high school like most people did, but I didn't really start becoming horny until I started watching Fairy Tail. Fairy Tail is a very horny anime. But I did not become the horny god that I am today until I started playing Fire Emblem. Fire Emblem is basically chess combined with horniness. Fire Emblem is extremely horny. It's the cause of all the horniness in the world, and I will not have become the horny god that I am today without playing Fire Emblem. So thank you, Fire Emblem. The Lone M asks, why are you so horny 24/7? Man, you guys are asking the good questions from the get-go, huh? I'm so horny 24/7 because of my interests and hobbies. I love games like Danganronpa, Fire Emblem, Persona, just really horny games in general. I'm also an avid viewer of hentai. I watch Fairy Tail, as mentioned earlier. Yeah, I'm pretty much surrounded by horniness in general, and that's why I am horny 24/7. It's probably never going to be satiated. My horniness is here to stay forever. First Son V asks, how was your day? Do you ship anyone with Hagami? And by the way, you are an amazing homie. Aw, thanks, dude. You're an amazing dude, too. How was my day? My day was pretty good. Quarantine sucks. I really need a haircut. I think everybody needs a haircut at this point, but it's something we all have to deal with. But other than that, I'd say my day was pretty good. And do I ship anyone with Hagami? I do ship her with Kokoro. Obviously, they're both Genki girls. They want to make the world smile. They're just so cute together. Also, I do ship her with Saya. Saya's family owns the bakery. Hagami's family owns the butcher shop. And Hagami wants to collab with Saya. And also, they just have cute interactions with each other, especially the area conversations. They're just so adorable. I also started shipping her with Maya because their winter sporting event that they had together was the most adorable thing. Hagami teaching Maya how to ski, and the interactions were just so cute. I love Hagami, I love Maya, they're just so cute together, it's unreal. Elias, aka Lissa's best waifu, who's a mod on my channel, asks, what inspired you to make a YouTube channel, and where do I see myself going? Well, I'm going to give a little bit of lore here. I actually made videos around 2007. Yeah, way back in the day when YouTube was still new and still fairly niche. I made magic videos, and what inspired me to make magic videos was this YouTuber named MadV. Most of you guys are probably too young to even know who MadV is, but if you want to look him up, look him up. He doesn't do magic videos anymore. But yeah, that's what inspired me to make videos. Currently, I'd say Fither, Sir Lionheart, Johnny Awesome, Hayden, a few people inspired me to make a YouTube channel. I just love seeing them stream, have fun, make videos, and just overall interacting with their audience. That's the thing I really like the most about YouTube, is interacting with an audience of similar interests as you and learning more about the people you talk to and interact with. And where do I see myself going? Honestly, I'm just gonna keep making videos for now and streaming. Maybe it'll go somewhere, but for now, I'm just enjoying the ride. I used to stress about growth before, but nowadays, I don't really stress about it too much. It's fun to me now. I really generally love what I'm doing, and to be honest, wherever it goes, but overall I'm just having fun. Ranit again asks, if someone were to break into your house and with your idol merch at gunpoint and ask who is better, Hagami, Nico, or Chihaya, who would you choose? Oh no, you're making me choose. Well, Nico unfortunately is my least favorite of the three. Even though I did a video about Nico, I love her to pieces, but out of those three, she is my least favorite. I still love Nico though. Between Hagami and Chihaya, I love Chihaya so much. Her episode in Idolmaster made me cry more than any other media in general. It was so touching, emotional. It was just like the perfect emotional episode. But unfortunately, I have to pick Hagami. It has to be Hagami. She's the mascot of my channel. One of my favorite fictional females of all time, if not my absolute favorite. She is just so amazing, cute, wants to make everyone smile. She has a pretty rough backstory, which I wish they would expand upon. Please, Bushiroad, expand on that. So yeah, I love Chihaya to pieces, but it has to go to Hagami. Samuel Cron asks, he has a bunch of questions actually. What makes Mia best girl? What is your favorite Fire Emblem class? Which game is your favorite Fire Emblem game? What are your favorite anime or manga series? And what qualities make someone an absolute unit? I did a video about Mia, but the too long didn't read version is, Mia is competitive, she wants to prove that women can fight too, she's energetic, she's spunky, she has an amazing design. As of Radiant Dawn, in my opinion, she is the best looking girl in Tellius. She uses swords, True Blade is one of my favorite classes of all time, and her supports, especially the ones with Riss and Ileana, are just so cute and endearing. She is amazing, Mia is best girl, hands down. What's my favorite Fire Emblem class? If you were to ask me what Fire Emblem class I would be if I got Isekai'd into Fire Emblem, it would definitely be Swordsmaster or True Blade. But my favorite class has to be Great Knight. Great Knight just looks so cool. When I first played Awakening, I saw Frederick. He just looks so badass with all that armor. Granted, that armor is probably heavy as shit, but it still looks cool nonetheless. And also the horse head armor. As a class, they're still overshadowed by Paladins, but that's because Paladins have been shown to be consistently one of the best classes ever. And in Sacred Stones, Great Knights are just, they're a mess, for lack of a better word. But Awakening onwards definitely helped them, gave them a boost. They have really good defensive capabilities. They're just a really good class all around. Not as good as Paladins, but you can get away with a Great Knight. I made Silas a Great Knight in Fates, and he put in work. More work than most of my other units. Great Knights are just cool. What's my favorite Fire Emblem game? Path of Radiance. I love Path of Radiance to pieces. Great characters, great story, great gameplay. My only gripes with the game would be Chapter 25 is an absolute pain in the dick, and the supports are kind of unfulfilling in that no one really gets married to each other. There's no ending. Well, I mean, Radiant Dawn kind of fixes that, but still, I would have really loved to have Path of Radiance have true endings to their supports, but I guess they didn't do that because they knew Radiant Dawn was going to come anyway. And of course, Path of Radiance is the debut of best girl, Mia. What's my favorite anime or manga series? Hunter x Hunter. Hunter x Hunter is incredible. On my anime list, I've completed almost 300 anime. That's a lot of anime, I know. And Hunter x Hunter is still above each and every one of them. Hunter x Hunter, in my opinion, is the greatest anime of all time. It's just in a league of its own. There's nothing like Hunter x Hunter out there. It's incredible, great characters, story is unbelievable, fights are insane, and Madhouse did the anime so much justice. Only gripe is that the first three episodes are kind of whack, and there are two recap episodes, but they're just recap episodes, you can skip them. But after those first three episodes, and not counting the recap episodes, there was never a time where I was bored watching the show. I was always engaged, always felt some kind of emotion watching it. Hunter x Hunter is just a phenomenal show. If you have time to watch it, please watch it. That's the anime you should be watching during this quarantine. Hunter x Hunter. And what qualities make someone an absolute unit? Great growths, great bases, availability, are they easy to recruit, what class they are, their weapon rank, how many supports do they have, and probably the most important thing would be...
FAT ASSES!
Fither asks, what is the appeal of armpits? I feel as if many weak-minded people do not fully comprehend why they're so good. Please explain. Thank you. Well, since you asked, I'll be glad to drop some knowledge on you guys. Armpits are this mysterious body part. They are uncharted territory. They are this grand hole on a person's body that you just want to explore no matter the cost. When you look at art of Mia from Fire Emblem and she's showing her pits like it's nobody's business, you just want to see them. You just want to explore that region, that uncharted territory. That's why armpits are so appealing. They are mysterious. And they're also safe for work. You can't be showing titties. You can't be showing
fat asses.
You can't be showing thighs sometimes. But armpits, that's fair game. That is perfectly safe. Armpits are goated. Dragon Kid asks, do you think there are card effect 101 classes in Yu-Gi-Oh! GX? I like to believe they are. They have gym class and dueling chemistry. I don't know what the fuck dueling chemistry is. So I like to imagine they do have card effect 101 classes. There has to be. That's like 80% of the curriculum right there. That'd be cool if Konami released a full curriculum list of every class in Duel Academy. Who knows, maybe I'll open up a Duel Academy and teach everyone how to play some children's card games. Doroth Inquisition, aka Ion, asks, why are muscle girls superior? Why are muscle girls superior? Because muscles are superior. Even more so than armpits. I know I've praised armpits a lot before, but muscles are even a step further. Muscles are so hot and universally accepted. A lot of people don't accept tits. A lot of people don't accept
fat asses.
A lot of people don't accept thighs. They don't even accept armpits, but muscles. Muscles are much more accepted than any of those things put together. And also, how hot would it be if a muscle girl just beat the shit out of you? I don't know, I'd find that pretty hot. Thank God I watched Jormungand and opened my eyes to see the true beauty of a jacked woman. Valmet is best girl, don't at me. GNS asks, alright, the question that separates the boys from the men, oh, what is it? Velma or Daphne? Oh, Velma, dude. You kidding me? Daphne's fine, but why wouldn't you choose Velma? Biggest Koopa asks, how much do you like Fire Emblem Path of Radiance from 1 to 10? 1,000. Path of Radiance, like I said before, is an incredible game. As a starting point, it is a good starting point, but the reason I don't say you should start with Path of Radiance is because the same reason I say you shouldn't start with Final Fantasy IX as your first Final Fantasy is that the games are just so good that you need to play the other games to really appreciate the greatness of Path of Radiance and Final Fantasy IX. I love Path of Radiance to pieces. Yuri Vaga asks, when will you play Yakuza? When I'm not lazy, which is probably never. I'm just kidding. Maybe one day I'll play it. It looks interesting. The gameplay looks pretty fun, so who knows? Maybe I'll give it a chance one of these days. Ranit again asks, is Thracia the cause of all the world's problems? Yes. Thracia causes every single problem known to man. Thracia is a scourge that needs to be erased from this planet. The world would have been a much better place had Thracia not come into existence. Thracia is just a plague, and we need to get rid of it. And the last Discord question comes from, again, Elias, aka Lissa's best waifu. If you could be stuck in any Fire Emblem world, which would it be post-war so you don't die at all? If I could be a Sekai into any Fire Emblem world, it would definitely be Tellius. Why? One reason only. Mia. Actually make that two reasons, Tanith. Actually make that three reasons, Titania. Actually, holy fuck, Tellius has a lot of great women. I know I'm missing out on not going to Foldin because Shami is there and I won't get to see Shami. I love Shamir to pieces. She is awesome. But ultimately, Mia is my waifu. And wouldn't you want to take the opportunity to see your waifu as well? I would. And that's why I would choose Tellius, because I would go and marry Mia. She'll probably kick my ass, but you know what? I would enjoy it. And that's it for the Discord questions. Moving on to the YouTube questions. MJPlayer64 asks, congrats, dude. Aw, thanks, man. Okay, here's my question. Who is your favorite Persona girl in each game? Or if that question is too boring, would you be okay with a Dead or Alive Extreme type game, but with Persona girls instead? Oh, the first question's not boring. Don't worry about it, man. So I never played Persona 1, but I did play Persona 2 Innocent Sin. I would have to say my favorite girl is Yukino. Yukino is so awesome in that game. I love how caring she is, despite looking like a thug. I don't know. She has like this thug design. It looks really hot, by the way. And she was overall just a great character. In Persona 3, it's Mitsuru. I love her personality. I love that she's tough, takes no nonsense from anyone. Design-wise, really attractive. I love redheads. And in Ultimax, oh my, step on me, mommy. Her persona, in my opinion, is one of the best designed personas in Persona 3. And also, her social link is so adorable, especially when she eats hamburgers. That is the cutest thing I've ever seen in a Persona game. Mitsuru is just awesome all around. In Persona 4, honestly, it's Yukiko. I know, not a lot of people like Yukiko that much, but I love her. Design-wise, she is beautiful, she's elegant, she's also Fire Element, and I love Fire Element Persona users. Also, her laugh is so funny. I love her laugh. A lot of people say it's annoying. I love her laugh. Chie, please let her laugh. I want to hear that adorable laugh all day. Okay, maybe not all day, but I want to hear that laugh. In Persona 5, it's An, no doubt about that. I made a video about An, but I still don't think I did her enough justice. An is incredible, I love her personality, she's very upbeat, but also very tough. Design-wise, extremely attractive. Outside of Mitsuru, she is the most attractive Persona girl in my opinion. Carmen is also a badass persona, again, Fire Element. And I would say as a party member, in my opinion, she's probably the best party member Persona 5 besides Joker. Although in Persona 5, there really is no bad party members. You could literally have a party of whatever you want and still do very well. Her confidant was also one of the best in the game. And she's just so cute when she wants to be. She's just amazing. I love An so much. She is incredible. An Takamaki, best persona girl by far. Vortex Oblivion says, you didn't show any muscle anime girls there, you fraud, unsubscribed, congrats for 500 followers, man. Aw, thanks man, you are awesome. And I'm so sorry for no muscular anime girls, I'll show them right now. What do you think about this one? Or this one? Or this one? Thanks again, dude. Yuki says, congrats, thanks so much, Yuki. My question, what is your favorite dinosaur? I'm not too big on dinosaurs, but I'm gonna say the T-Rex. I know, basic bitch answer, but it has to be the T-Rex. It's the most popular one, and like I said, I'm not that big on dinosaurs, but I always love the T-Rex. It looks cool. Francie asks, you know it's an impromptu video when the Persona 5 music starts playing. That's true. Congrats on the subs, thanks man. Why is Super Broly the best version of Broly in all the Dragon Ball continuity? It's funny because I never saw the new Broly movie, but if I had to guess, it would probably be because he is evil for reasons other than sleep. The fact that Goku didn't let me sleep as a baby, even though he was a baby as well because he was crying as a baby. It's not like babies cry or anything. That was the stupidest reason I've ever heard of a villain being evil. I would have rather just prefer him to be evil just for the fuck of it, rather than because my sleep was disturbed as a baby by another baby. That was so ridiculous. Whoever thought that was a good idea really needs a kick in the ass. So I'm pretty sure in the new Broly movie, he has better reasons for being evil. Which, by the way, I heard the new Broly movie was great. If you guys haven't seen it yet, I would suggest go seeing it. I need to see it one of these days myself. And the last YouTube question is GNS asking, did puberty hit you between this and the last video? You sound different. The last video I didn't record on my mic. Basically what I did was I went downstairs into my guest room and recorded on my phone. And my guest room is pretty small, so sounds and volumes were just off. And also I wasn't feeling physically well, I was a little sick. I'm fine now, don't worry guys. And I even listened to the video, I was like, yeah, I sound really weird. So I apologize for that. Hopefully I sound better in this video. And that's it for the YouTube questions. And moving on to the Twitter questions, we only have one question. And it's from Yuri again saying, play Yakuza Van. One day. Maybe. One day I'll play it. And that is it for the questions. Thank you guys again so much for asking them. Now, a quick announcement regarding streaming. We recently beat Fire Emblem New Mr. The Emblem, and I'm currently playing Danganronpa 1. My plan is to finish out Danganronpa 1 from here on out, and after I do that, I'm going to be getting a new computer. Yes, it's about time I get a new toaster. I'll miss the old toaster, man. The old toaster has been with me for so long. I'll miss you, buddy. And in terms of streaming after I get my new toaster, I'll be streaming two games, one of them obviously being Danganronpa 2 because I like Danganronpa now, but also we will also be streaming Fire Emblem Path of Radiance. You heard me answering the questions of why I love this game so much, and we are finally going to play it. And who knows, maybe I'll even have a webcam so my beautiful face can grace your computer screens. And that's pretty much it for the streaming announcement. Thank you guys again so much for 500 subscribers. We're only going to keep going and growing. And I'm going to keep making content that you guys want to see, that I want to make, and content that I just generally have fun doing. And also streaming and interacting with you guys through YouTube, Discord, Twitter. Again, thank you guys so much. Give yourselves a nice round of applause. We're going to keep going. I'll see you next time. Peace. Have a great day.